Six LEDs. Three resistors. Three outputs from an Arduino. What manner of black magic be this? It's not magic at all. It's charlieplexing. Hey, what's happening, guys? Today we're going to talk about charlieplexing. It's like multiplexing, but it's a little bit different in that it uses tri-state logic. If you don't know what tri-state logic is, it means that each pin from our Arduino can have three separate states. It can be high, it can be low, or it can be what we call high Z, or an input state. And by using this technique, you can control multiple LEDs with a very few number of pins. For instance, if you look here, we are controlling six LEDs with three pins. And the way we do that is simply by lining them up in opposite polarity in a little bit of interconnecting, which we're going to talk about right now. Okay, so here's our circuit diagram, but first let's talk about the formula for figuring out charlieplexing. And it's called charlieplexing because it was discovered by a guy named Charlie Allen somewhere in the 90s, I forget exactly when. But the formula for figuring out how many LEDs you can control is N times N minus 1. So in this case, we have four resistors, four inputs. So it's 4 times 4 minus 1, or 4 times 3, or 12. Now I'm only doing 6 just to keep things simple here, but I'll explain to you how you can do the whole 12. So we start with input pins or output pins from our Arduino. We're using pins 8, 9, 10, 11. You can use any pins you want. Just did these because they're close together and because they line up nice and straight. So D1 and D2 are connected between input 1 and input 2, which, you know, we're going to call these resistors our inputs. So between R1 and R2, we connect D1 and D2 in opposite polarity. Then between R2 and R3, which is input 2 and input 3, we connect D3 and D4 again in opposite polarity. And then between input 3 and input 4, we connect D5 and D6 in opposite polarity again. And that is really all it takes, because what we're doing here with our programming is we're saying, you know, make this pin high, make this pin low, this one lights up. Make this pin high, make this pin low, this one lights up. Then we say, make these two inputs, they both go blank. Make this one input, they both go blank. Make this one high, this one low, this one high, this one low. You get the idea. Now, if you want to add more, there's D5, there's D6. Say you want to add D7 and D8. Well, they just go between 1 and 3 like that. And then you can add 9 and 10, which go between pins 2 and 4. Let me draw it out for you. Okay, I hope this makes some sense to you. Here's our LEDs down here, 1 through 12. And then here's which resistors they attach between. So resistors 1 and... LEDs 1 and 2 attach between resistors 1 and 2. 3 and 4 attach between 2 and 3. 5 and 6, between 3 and 4. 7 and 8 between 1 and 3, 9 and 10 between 2 and 4, and 11 and 12 between 1 and 4. So that's all the connection that there is to making this work. And you can see it's really pretty simple how everything goes together. And I mean, why do you want to do this? Well, say you're working on a project and you've got a temperature sensor and you've got a relay and you know, I mean, how many digital pins do we really get on an Arduino? 13 pins. Let's say you've got a I can't even think of the word I'm looking for, an LCD display. You know, that's going to take up a majority of your pins, so you've only got a few pins left and you still want to realize some LEDs. Well, this is a great technique for doing it. You can control, you know, 12 LEDs with 4 pins. Everything is just really, really simple the way it goes together. Let me show you the code. It's set up for the full 12 LEDs. So if you want to realize the entire thing, but there's a way to change it to any number of LEDs you have, and it's simply by changing a variable. I'll show you that. Let's hop over to the computer. All right, here's the code for the Charlie plexing demo. The first thing we do is just define our pins. You could just as easily call the pin numbers, but it just makes it easier to say A, B, C, and D. And then we're going to set up pin config and a pin state, which we're going to use to swap them between high, low, and input. Now here's where I told you could change the number of LEDs you're using. I've got it set up for the entire 12. You can make it as low as you want. I mean, if you go anywhere below 6, it's really not worth doing, because then you have the same number of inputs as you do LEDs, but you know, whatever. So now we simply create a matrix, 2 rows, 4 columns, or that two columns, 4 rows. And we have A, B, C, and D, our pin config. See how they go output, output, input, input, high, low, low, low. That turns on 1. Then we have output, output, input, input, low, high. That turns on that one. Do you see what's going on here? Then the next one turns on this one. And simply by switching through these one at a time, we can change which LEDs are on. And we do that right here. So we say pin mode. A, that's pin 8, matrix LED, which one, then our pin config, then we do B, C, and D. So we're setting the mode, whether it's, you know, an input or an output. Then we do our digital write, which is our state, whether it's high or low. So you have to have 2 lines for each of these. I hope that makes sense to you. You have to tell it whether it's an input or an output first, and then you have to tell it high or low. Why do we need to do that? Okay, so by telling it input or output, we are switching everything connected to that pin on or off. Basically, it's just an off. If it's set for an output, they'll be on depending upon the pin state, but if we set it for an input, everything connected to it will be off. Then we can come down here and we can set it high or low. High or low controls which of the 2 LEDs on that particular pin will turn on. If it's high, one will turn on because it will be sourcing the current. If it's low, the other one will turn on because it will be sinking the current. I hope that makes sense. And then down here, we just come down here and we count up to a number of LEDs, and then there's our delay. No big deal. Now, why does it always do that? Pain in the butt. All right. Hope that makes sense. Okay, so one thing to keep in mind is, since this is a form of multiplexing, you can make these go as fast as you want. And you don't have to use just LEDs. You can use a 7-segment LED, bar graphs, whatever you want. Make them go fast enough, they'll go faster than the eye can differentiate, and it'll look like things are on all the time. That's how we multiplex 7-segment LEDs. But if you don't have enough pins for a 7-segment LED, keep charlieplexing in your pocket. It's a pretty cool technique to use. I know it can seem a little bit confusing at first, but if you draw out the circuit, it'll make sense to you. All right? I hope you guys enjoyed this. If you did, give me a thumbs up. Feel free to comment, share, and don't forget to subscribe. Big thanks to all my patrons. Big thanks to you guys for watching. That's it. I'm out. Peace.